ready to match the star, William Shatner, Rhett Sommers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Julie Harris, Richard Dawson, and Barry Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rammer.
Thank you, Johnny Olsen, and friends. And are you my friends?
Oh,
are you my friends? I know the regulars are my friends. How are you?
Okay.
We're delighted to see you. Listen, tell us the date on that special that's going to be on CBS.
CBS, December 18th.
December 18th. And it's called?
The 10th Level.
The 10th Level. Okay. Will you watch that, too?
I'd like to.
Well, he'll watch yours if you'll watch his. Now, what's the name of yours? Oh, you made a feature-length film.
Called The Hiding Place.
The Hiding Place,
that's
right.
Wonderful. Okay.
Right. Of course, he'll watch on the Family Holdback. I'll watch on the Family Holdback.
Good.
For a nickel. Let's say hello to our champ. Here's Ann Harper. Well, Ann, this is the moment. You got $600, you won the game, and you won the first part of the audience match to the tune of $500. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. I see that puts a smile on your face.
Yes,
it does. What if you don't win the $5,000?
Oh, I'll be a happy person, all in all.
Well, that's a good attitude. We wish you the best of luck, Ann. We're going to stop now for a moment or so and pass along these messages. You come back and see if she's going to win that $5,000. Here we are with this sweet, attractive lady named Ann Harper, who's now going to try to collect $5,000. Now, I remind you, Ann, in order to get the $5,000, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly head-to-head. And it's time for you to choose one now. Have you thought it over?
Sure. Richard.
Richard, you are chosen. Okay, Ann, you face me if you would, please. Right, like that. Okay, I will get the $5,000 number, which reads as follows. Blank machine. Blank machine. Now, he's finished. And we ask you to give us a response, one you think will match his. Blank machine.
Sewing machine.
Sewing machine. Okay. Lukewarm applause for sewing machine. And we'll find out now if you do indeed match Richard and get the $5,000. Richard, what do you say?
Yeah, I thought of that, Donald. But you just look more of a gambler. I thought a slot machine.
Slot machine.
She
said she'd be happy if she didn't win the money. If she's happy.
I'm sorry for you.
All right, we'll carry on.
Slot machine. Well, you're still the champ now. You got the 600. Nobody's going to take that away from you, and you're going to meet another player. You ready for that?
Sure.
Okay, let's welcome Charles Moeller.
Hello, Charles.
Charles, you know Ann. Okay, Charles, we're delighted to meet you and have you with us here. Please tell us about yourself.
Well, it's good to be here. I'm from Missouri City, Texas, and I'm a ranch hand out there. I do a little scuba diving on the side.
In Texas?
Right.
On the side of Texas?
Yes, on that side, right.
How is it scuba diving in the sand out there in West Texas there? What do you scuba?
We scuba dive in the Gulf down there, right off Houston.
Oh, yes, right. And what do you get there? What do you shoot spears? And
No, I just go down and take a look.
Oh, really? Okay. Well, good luck to you here, Charles.
Wait a minute. Is he married?
We'd like to know.
Oh, yes. There's certain members of our celebrity panel would like to know if you are married.
No, thank you.
Now, wait a minute. Charles, it was a simple inquiry. We did not make an offer. A simple inquiry, a simple yes or no would have sufficed there. Okay.
Gene, I do have one more question.
What's that?
Are you a chauvinist pig?
That's a very nasty thing to say.
We say, good luck anyway, Charles.
Don't count on Fanny and I.
Right.
Fanny?
Now it's time to make a selection.
I would like A, please.
You would like A. Fat chance of your getting it. No, anything you say. You're the challenge. Here it is.
Right.
Albert, the inventor, said, my robot must be really nearsighted. Yesterday, I caught him dragging my blank into the bedroom. Robot, you know what a robot is? It's a mechanical man. Yes. Albert, the inventor, said my robot must be really nearsighted. Yesterday, I caught him dragging my blank into the bedroom. You think about that, Charles, while they're thinking about it and writing it here. Robot, you see, is the operative word here.
He hurt Fanny's feelings.
Fanny.
Because Fanny's looking for Mr. Wright.
No, he didn't hurt my feelings. It's all right. No, really. You didn't hurt my feelings at all. No, really, honey. Don't feel bad.
Just write your answer.
I mean, I wasn't asking Mary.
Okay, Camille, that's Mary. Enough. Julie Harris will do the acting. You write your answer.
I've told her there's no such thing as Mr. Wright, but she's very young.
All right, everybody ready now. Put it in there and slot it away we go. Charles, Albert the inventor said, my robot must be really nearsighted. Yesterday, I caught him dragging my blank into the bedroom.
My washing machine.
Washing machine.
Right.
Hold on now. Just a darn minute. A robot is a mechanical device. And it's perfectly logical in his mind that a mechanical device would fall in love with another mechanical device and drag it into the bedroom.
Now his mechanical device would say, no, thank you.
What do you say?
Not only is a robot a mechanical device,
yes.
It's an electronic device.
Yes.
He fell in love with the TV set.
TV set. All right, what do you say, Brett? What about this robot?
You know that Fanny's one of my dearest friends.
Yes.
She's never going to speak to me again. I said, washing machine, oh, Fanny.
May I respectfully suggest you leave the acting to Julie.
Oh, okay.
Play it straight there. Charles.
He insulted our women folk.
He did. The flower.
I can be as good as Glenn Ford on that series, too. He insulted our women folk.
He did, indeed.
I said why.
Why? All right, Julie Harris.
All right.
My robot must be really nearsighted. Yesterday I caught him dragging my, washing machine into the bedroom. And you said wife. All right.
This is a talking part. You can speak. All right. Pantomime, we get Marcel.
That's good.
I'm surprised at you.
Now, Richard, you're right.
Well, I liked Ann's answer so much the last time.
Ann, oh yes.
Read the question, please.
My robot must be really nearsighted. Yesterday, I caught him dragging my blank into the bedroom.
My sewing machine.
Say, that was her answer.
Ann
said sewing machine. Now, Fanny.
Hi, hon.
Are you going to retaliate?
No. I have three Alabama Highway Patrolmen that are waiting for me backstage that would like to talk to you. No, I said, unfortunately, I'm sorry, I did say wife.
Wife. So that's one for you, Charles, and now we'll get to yours in a moment or so, but right now we want to get to this, so pay attention. Ready. Here we go. Second half of round one. Ready, Ann. This is your first one in this game. Steve said, I wanted a swimming pool cheap, so I bought a do-it-yourself swimming pool kit. Was I robbed? All they gave me was 10,000 gallons of water and a blank. Wanted a swimming pool. Cheap, very inexpensive pool, and he bought a do-it-yourself swimming pool kit. All he got was 10,000 gallons of water and a blank. Good girl.
I love my ass.
That's a good one. That's a good one. Very good. Yes. All right, Charles, make up your mind. Okay, he's got one, so I shall wend my way over to Ann Harper and ask her. Steve said I wanted a swimming pool cheap, so I bought myself a do-it-yourself swimming pool kit, and was I robbed? All they gave me was 10,000 gallons of water and a blank.
A diving board.
A diving board. That's a possibility. But not exactly what we had in mind.
Ann does W.C. Fields tickets on the food.
She does, indeed. Now, Bill.
Well, well.
Now, Bill?
Now, Bill.
Now, Bill.
Now.
If he had 10,000 gallons and a small pail, he'd have quite a swimming pool, wouldn't he?
A pail.
And he would...
That's right.
Don't boo him. It's so humiliating, it shouldn't even be booed.
Right.
Now you're going to have this wonderful answer coming up.
What does it say?
Oh, I'm sorry. Somebody else must have written it for me. I said in a plug.
In a plug.
I'll tear that for
Charles, you got a winner?
In keeping with a level of brilliant answers, I said a bottle of chlorine.
A bottle of chlorine.
Thank you so much.
That got one applaud.
I wanted the swimming pool cheap, so I bought myself a do-it-yourself swimming pool kit, and all they gave me was 10,000 gallons of water and a diving board, according to Anne. What do you say, Julie?
A spade.
A spade. All right, Richard.
Well, let me take, where were we? Oh, yes.
All they gave me was 10,000 gallons of water and a diving board.
Dollars of water and a big plastic baggie.
And a baggie. Now.
Let me see, where were we? Nancy Drew had just discovered the secret of the old
right. clock. Yeah, that's it.
Oh, that. Now, I said shovel.
A shovel.
That's a good answer.
So there's round one for you, 1-0, favorite Charles. And Charles, we ask you to make your selection again.
I'll try B this time, please.
B it is, all right. One person does not play, that's Brett.
Shh.
Here it is. When King Kong wants a close shave, he lies on his back and he has a blank run over his face. That's what happens when King Kong wants a close shave. Just lies on his back and this has a blank run over his face.
Do you know that Bill Shatner and Charles Nelson Reilly both did a play with Julie Harris?
At different times? What play did you do with her?
I believe so.
I did A Shot in the Dark a long time ago on Broadway. We had a year's run, Julie and I.
Yes, indeed. I do remember that. I do remember that. And you were both marvelous in it. What did you do?
Skyscraper with Ms. Harris.
Right.
And an unknown Peter Marshall.
Never
I
heard of him.
I don't know what business he went into.
Never heard of him again after that.
Never heard of him.
All right.
I did a television show with Miss Harris.
Okay. You did a television show with Miss Harris.
Yes.
What was that?
Match Game.
Match Game.
It's going on my resume.
Yeah. It's in your resume. Charles, are you ready?
Yes.
When King Kong wants a close shave, he lies on his back and has a blank run over his face.
A lawnmower.
A lawnmower. Lawnmower is good.
What did he say?
He said a lawnmower and got a standing ovation.
Well, I have such a feeling of satisfaction tonight.
You have lawnmower. Okay, Charles, you got one.
You turned against Fanny?
No, but they haven't stood for me, do
you? Yes. Now, CNR.
He still insulted our women folk.
Yes.
And I'm still going to get that part on a family series, and I said lawnmower despite myself.
King Kong wants close shave, lies on his back, has a blank run over his face, and Charles did a lawnmower. What do you say, honey?
Razorback hog.
A razorback hog. Now, wait a minute.
That's a really good
one. You dare to boo this lady getting a brilliant and creative answer like that?
He is a laugher, too.
Right.
A lawnmower can't run, but a razorback hog can.
That's right. Well, you indeed.
Push your luck. You got a sitting ovation.
Okay, Richard, he lies on his back and has a blank run over his face.
I'm not surprised, sir. Now, if I put sewing machine again here, you'd get quite testy, wouldn't you, young man? You've got a big, broad shoulder there, so cowardly, I wrote lawnmower.
That's what he said. That's 4-4. Now, yes. All is forgiven. What do you say?
All is forgiven?
Right.
No, you didn't mean that personally,
did
you?
I didn't mean that personally,
See,
no.
I didn't think so. Are you sure?
Yeah.
Sewing machine. No, it's lawnmower.
Lawnmower. That's another one for him. So, 5-2. Nice score. You got a chance at it here. But right now, we're going to give you a chance to watch this message. Oh, dear me. Where are we? Oh, here we are. Are you ready? You know what you have to do?
Yes.
You have to match 5 celebrities to tie. 6 will win. Ready?
Yes.
It's easy for you, huh? It's difficult for me. Easy for you. Geronimo said, Sitting Bull
drink whole keg of beer. Now, him blanking bull.
Would you repeat that? Gene, would you repeat that, please?
What is it, again?
Sitting Geronimo.
Now, Harris is going to be gone next week, and you're going to be kissing my blank, so come over here and read that question again. Never mind hanging around her.
Geronimo said, sitting bull, drink whole keg of beer. Now, him blanking bull.
Oh, I get it.
Blanking?
Yeah, an ING in the I blanking bull.
I love my answer.
Blanking bull.
Would you repeat that once more?
Geronimo said, sitting bull, drink whole keg of beer. Now, him blanking bull.
I can't
not
see
not sitting bull anymore.
No keg of beer?
Good. That's it? That's a good one. There we go. Now, let's see. Two, three are still...
Now, that's clever. I wish I'd thought of that.
Okay. Now, we're all set.
Yes, I'd like to.
Ann Harper.
Yes.
Geronimo said, sitting bull, drink whole keg of beer. Now, him blanking bull.
Kissing.
Kissing bull.
Oh, beer. Ann.
Make you kiss?
Sure.
You kiss much when you drink beer? You come to my dressing room. I have six-pack.
I have a vision of Sitting Bull standing in the mesa, overlooking, looking down, getting rid of the beer. Standing Bull.
Standing Bull. Got to match everybody else to stay in the business here, Ann. Here we go with Brett.
Oh, no.
She says kissing. That's what she wants.
Oh, golly, I feel so terrible because she's so cute and adorable. And I used to drink beer. I gave it up.
Why?
Because you turn into Tinkling Bull.
Tinkling Bull. How's the rest of you have?
Show and tell. Okay. Congratulations to you.
You hang around here for a second. Would you do that? Now, Ann, we're going to part company here, but I'm glad you're going to go with a little bundle of money here. $600 for you, together with our best wishes
thank
to
you.
Ann Harper.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Bye. Bye.
Isn't she darling? Yeah. Now, Charles, here it is. It's all for you, sir. Here it is, the big super. You'll take it all? Well, you got to say a few magic words before you take it all, Charles. And we'll begin right now. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Banjo blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. $250 for the middle one and $100 for the bottom one. Whom do you call on?
I'll call on Fanny first.
Yes,
what do you
I
say,
hope
Fanny?
So.
I'm not going to tell it. banjo player.
Banjo player.
Yeah.
Richard? Richard?
Charles, I didn't realize you were so tall. I'd like to apologize for any silly little... You know how show people are.
Yes, right. We were just funning you.
Paul just done with good humor. Did he buy that, Julie? Banjo on my knee.
Banjo on my knee.
I said it first.
Come from Alabama with a banjo on my knee.
Well, no, she
the way?
Comes from Alabama and
oh,
I have
Susanna,
a banjo
Susanna, don't you cry for me. All right, what else?
And Charles, please.
Charles?
I say... I don't need any help from you, sugar. I say banjo eyes.
Okay, there you go. Banjo eyes, banjo on my knee, and banjo player.
Banjo player, please.
Banjo player is the one that Fanny gave him, and let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Banjo eyes. All right, let's see the banjo player.
I want to thank the audience for that round of applause.
Here's the $250 response. Banjo player, congratulations, you got it. Okay. Let's see what's under the $500 number. Slide it, Earl. Banjo on my knee is the one that Richard gave you. Charles, that means you're going to be playing for $2,500 additional. But before we can have a shot at this, we got to have a shot at this here commercial. We just got 5 seconds, and I can't tell you how wonderful you are in 5 seconds. Next time, these are the people who will be on the stage.
Joe Silver, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Esther Rowe, Richard Dawson, Fanny Flagg.
And goodbye.
You know what happened?